Greetings, guys. This is your brother in the kingdom, Emmanuel Destiny. Welcome to another valuable video. As you can see by the title, I really want to talk about setting you up for the year as a trader. I saw a lot of people struggle last year, not because they cannot trade, but because they don't have a plan that is set in place to govern them in order to be profitable traders. Okay, so that's what I want to be talking about today. I'm going to be talking about how to create a trading plan. What is a trading plan? What is the importance of that? And of course, we're just going to go and sit down and just talk. Obviously, right now, I'm just downstairs. I'm just going to be going upstairs, sit down on the desk, just talk to you, because I feel it very much befitting that we start with this. Reason why is important, that a lot of people with the skill that they have, they may be able to establish discipline, they may be able to establish consistency, because without discipline, one is not going to be consistent. So that's what we're going to be doing right now. Having a trading plan is paramount to ensuring that you achieve your goals. And of course, a trading plan, rather, it acts as a blueprint to your trading, and it should highlight a lot of things about your trading, and also, for example, your time commitments, your available funds, your risk towards ratio. But I'm gonna break it down for you. And the main question to a lot of people who don't know anything about a trading plan is, why is it important to have a trading plan? Number one, a trading plan will keep you headed in the right direction. So a lot of people, hence I've said it to my students, without a trading plan, you trade like a headless chicken. What was not your intention will definitely now catch your attention, because there is no sort of plan that governs you as a trader. And I've seen, as I said it, I've seen a lot of people fail this year, not because, or rather last year, 2021, not because they don't have the right skill, but because they don't have the right system and rather plan that governs them. So number one, it keeps your head in the right decision. Number two, successful trading, it's not just a hobby, it's a business, and a successful business, and you will have a plan, or you will need a plan. So many people, they don't understand, and they just come into the trading and they will say, well, I'm just doing it as a side income, I'm just doing it as a hobby. And you don't understand that this is actually a business. The moment you step into trading, you are an entrepreneur. And now, of course, before one has to start a business, you're gonna need a business plan. And so many people, they just jump into trading without an actual plan that really governs them in order to trade. So I'm just gonna have my notes here in order to stop looking the other side. So, but what I need to say is that, as much as it's very much important that one, when they start a classic business, they need a business plan, it's also very much important that one also have a trading plan before you can actually go live. If you're still on a demo, practicing backtesting, that's okay. But the moment you are telling yourself that you actually just wanna go to a real account, you need to have a game plan, something that really governs you to say, that is what I'm actually gonna do to make sure that I do not lose the account, lose my funds, to make sure that I am not emotionally taken by the market, because the market sometimes can really be tricky, and you want to make sure that your head is in the right space emotionally, so as well mentally speaking, that you are mentally healthy as a trader. Okay, so that's the second point there, and it's more or less two points what I just wanted to say. When you're trading, have the mentality of a business plan, then you know that even a business plan has got a lot of objectives, has the vision laid out. A lot of people, you don't see results because there's no vision, and because you have no vision, hence you are just perishing. Oh my God, but we are helping you today. And I just want to speak about the basics of a trading plan. So this is what includes a trading plan. And I believe after watching this video, a lot of you guys are just going to be, you know, helped by this content, because as I said, I'm going to be doing a lot of content that's going to be helping you guys to just, you know, be up there as a trader. And I believe a trading plan really set me up, especially those who are in like fund challenges, you know, in FTMOs and my Forex fund and all of these challenges. It's very much important that you can have a trading plan before you can go into such, because I mean, you're given an opportunity to trade a large capital, but if you forfeit it because you're just having a great skill is not enough. You need the right way to think. You need a system. So, of course, the basics of a trading plan. Number one, create a trading system. And I don't mean a trading robot. I mean a system, a set of rules put in place in order to govern you. So a trading system is the foundation of your trading, and should test it for 1 month or two before going into a real account. So it's something that you've already back tested. It's something that it has already proven that it really shows you results. So the first thing that a trading system should have, time frames you will use. A lot of people don't know that. They're all over the place. Decide which time frames favor you, which time frames build up this routine. So the time frame you will use. Number two, the entry and exit signal, or rather, what is your catalyst to enter a trade? So you need to develop that. Number three, the maximum percentage that you will risk on each trade. You need to decide. A lot of people risk as if they have a million in the account already. You don't have that. You need to decide that you're not going to be taken emotionally by a trade. You're going to do it with the right, rather mentality, so speaking. Okay, so that's what I really want to talk about right now. I'm going to give you the next point. So the next point there is, how many lots are you going to use? A lot of people, you just go ahead and use any lot. You need to realize how many lots are you going to use in terms of either if you're trading debt or debt. How much lots, as much as you've decided the percentage, how much lots you're going to use. So that's a trading system that will govern you, that you put in place. So let's go back. The time frames you'll use, your catalyst to enter and exit the trade, the maximum percentage, and also the lots that you'll use. Okay, the next thing that really is in a trading plan, or rather, the next category is a trading routine. Okay, a trading routine is basically how you do things in a day as you go about trading. I will, by the grace of God, this year, do what we call, trading, or in a day of a forex trader, I will do it. But a trading routine is very much important, or part of your trading plan, because it directs you. It's what you do on a daily basis. So you need to build up a very systematic and program way that you do stuff, then you will ultimately see the same results. So that means that if you want to see yourself making $1,000 per day or per month or per week, then there must be something that you do in order to make that a reality. And you didn't just make it a reality by skill alone and tenacity and ambition. You want to have the right tools to govern you. Okay, so of course, the first thing there, when you will analyze. So you need to figure out, when do I really analyze the market? When do I plan my trades? Is it in the morning during the London session or pre-London? I'll go inside the market, just analyze and be ready. As well as number two, when do you really watch the market to place trades? So when do you plan on taking trades? I normally take my trades during the London session, especially DAX. That's when I normally take my trades. So I have systematically put myself in a program that I know that each and every time at 10 a.m. South African time, I'm taking trades on DAX. Okay, just an example there. Of course, the other plan, or rather the other point, is when will you check the market during the day? So a lot of people become market parasites. They become market paralyzed in a way that you're always on your screen so many times of the day. And it's very much important that you don't allow yourself to go into that space unless you're still learning. But if you're a professional trader, because a trading plan sets you up to be a professional trader, don't stick on the screen so many times of the day. Take the trade. Once you've taken the trade, you'll come back again when you know that this is the time when you get or to place trades. You don't have to stick, because forex trading is supposed to give you more time, not take away a lot of time. Okay? And of course, another point that really is in a trading plan, or that you should consider, is what is your state of mind, or rather your mentality, I would call it. But I just put it as a question so that you can think about it. What is your state of mind each and every time when you're about to trade? Okay, and I'm just gonna give you a few points here. Well, I look for trading, or rather signals. Okay, signals is not just somebody giving you. As a trader, you look for a signal. That means an opportunity to enter. So there is a confluence that suggests to you that you enter the trade. So that's what I mean there. Will I look for signals and not guess which way the market is going? So a lot of people, especially if you are starting up as a beginner, or rather you just have a skill, a lot of people just go into guesswork and don't really know. So you need to build up that mentality to say, I don't just get moved. I need to see confluences before I go for a trade. The other thing, I will only trade in the direction of the trend. That's my thing. I will only trade in the direction of the trend. In normal cases, I will not trade reversals. I will trade in the direction because I have a higher probability trading with the trend rather than against the trend. Number three there, when I lose on a trade, I will see what I can learn and move on. A lot of people, immediately when you lose a trade, you wanna just trade without really composing yourself. And you don't understand the psychology behind it. You gotta compose yourself, calm down, you've lost money. Your mind feels like it's beaten up and defeated. And in that case, psychologically, you're gonna want to recover that. And in most cases, you lose the money that you've made because of that. So what you can do, step away from the market, learn from what made you lose. Write it down in a trading journal, then afterwards you move on to the next trade with the right mentality, not with the mentality of envy and paying back. Okay, otherwise you'll pay the money, or rather the market, more money. Okay, number four, if I'm not mistaken there. So the next point there is, I'll not be hard on myself for losing a trade. So of course, after you've lost the trade and you've learned, you need to also tell yourself within your mentality that you've built up to sustain you, to say you not be hard on yourself. There's some trades that even though there were high probability that all of, they had all of the confluences, you can still lose. I still lose even trades up to this day, but you should not be hard on yourself. As long as you've applied the right risk management parameters and you've lost a lot of money, because when you've in your trading system, it tells you how much percentage you're willing to lose. Therefore the emotions are just out of the window, because everything is preset for you, everything is already planned. So you do not do anything that you do not plan to do. So if you took a loss, you didn't lose much because you already planned to lose such a percentage. Okay, and I will use every trade as a learning experience. That's one thing that I do each and every, whether it's a profit or win, whether it was a right decision or wrong decision, you learn from it. So that's the attitude that you got to have. That's the mentality that one ought to have this year as you go about within this trading. Okay, so this is the last point that should be in a trading plan. What are my goals? A lot of people don't actually know, and a lot of people don't actually have written it down. Some people went on to write their New Year's resolutions, but you also need to write it for your trading. So this time I would advise you, after watching this video, take some time, think about what you want to accomplish as a trader. Then afterwards, these are the questions that you can ask yourself, right? Do I want to do trading for a living? Full-time trading is not, rather, as we say in South Africa, pap and flakes. It's not as easy as other people, you know, just portray to be. There's a lot that goes into trading. There's a lot that goes into being an entrepreneur. Some days are depressing. Some days are the best days. Some days you think that you've got it. Some days you're like, oh Lord, what am I doing? And you need to really prepare for that if you tell yourself that you're going to be doing this thing for full time, for a living, or are there other things that you're going to be doing and you're just combining everything. Another question, which is question number two, how much return can I realistically expect from trading based on the knowledge and the experience that I have. So a lot of people need to be realistic, and in so many times we're just in La La Land, and most of the time we're like, okay, from $10 I'm just gonna take it to 1 million, or rather from $10 I'm just gonna make 3 million. That's, you need to be really honest with yourself and be realistic with yourself to say, if I have this amount, if I have the skill, what can I do? What's my goal daily? How much money can I extract each and every day, or per week, or per month? You need to create that systematic way of doing this. I'm also just gonna give you a big testimony at the end right now. Okay, number three, your goals don't even have to be about making money. Some of you, this year can be a year of still learning the markets. The fact remains that you're not the same place you were at the beginning of the year. That's what the intention should be. Number four, maybe you would like to be more disciplined or gain more confidence. Some of you guys, maybe that's what you want to work for or want to work through. And I believe that this video will really be hitting that on point, on target, to say this is going to help you to gain more discipline, more confidence within your trading, because you can now see a good trade, a good system that you've put in place, and you're going to see, okay, things are now starting to climb, okay? And of course, these goals should be personalized, okay? If you are a mentor, maybe like me, you can have a group, or rather this goal that each and everybody can achieve. But most of these things should be personalized. And as well, what do you want to get out of this? A lot of us, financial breakthrough, some just a good learning experience, being well informed about the market, a lot of things. Ask yourself. And of course, when times get tough, you will use these answers as something to motivate you to push harder. Because a lot of people, you know, that's why you'll tell people that trading is so good, it's financially good for each and everybody. But they'll ask you, why is not everybody joining this thing? It's because it's not for everyone. A lot of people have joined, traded, and given up because they did not have a why. So it's very much important that as a trader, you can really, each and every time when the enemy, when a problem, when a setback comes, your why needs to be the biggest answer to it. Come on. Your why needs to be the biggest answer. So I just hope that what I just said within this video was really informative. Number one, a trading plan is what? A trading plan, it's basically a blueprint to your trading. It's a guideline, okay? And it should highlight all of these things that I just mentioned right now. I'm just going to give them to you again. Just going to give them to you. There we go. What should the trading plan highlight? A trading system. Okay, I did mention that. Just go back to the video. Trading system. Number two, a trading routine. What you do. And of course, a mentality that will keep you strong in hard times, as well as your goals. You should write down your goals to be able to have a why when those losses come in. As well as what I just wanted to share as a testimony. I don't really reveal much of my life, but one thing that I did that really, I'll just praise Jesus Christ for this, because he gave me wisdom. Money without wisdom is just useless. That's why even Solomon in the Bible went ahead and asked for wisdom, because he had everything. He didn't ask for more money. Because with wisdom, you can create multiple streams. That's why he was the richest man in the Bible. Now, as the Lord gave me wisdom, rather 2020, but I, of course, I was able to apply it 2022. And I want you to just also use this wisdom. Create three accounts. The first account will be what you call your weekly income. And then your second account should be what we call your monthly salary. So this is a constant amount that should come daily in your bank account. Your third one should be what you call your yearly income. So this is where you push as hard as you can with the right discipline, the most strictest risk management parameters, in order to make sure that you make a large amount of money. And of course, with that, I was able to purchase a house. I was able to do a lot of things, pay up debts and all of that with just those big accounts. A lot of you guys can pay up your college, school fees, buy a car, whatever the case may be. But your weekly one, now let's go back. Your weekly one is where, if you feel like you have a problem of greed, or you want to take those high risk trades, adrenaline, that's what you can do. You can make sure that you're doubling this account, flipping the account, whether you're just depositing a small amount like $100, you're taking it to 500. It's just where you play around with it. Just something that it's for transport money, or rather for going out with your wife, or anything. It's just loose cash that you just make. Then your monthly one, it's basically a standard account that you just make money from, especially if you are self-employed and you're an entrepreneur like me. It's very much important that you can keep even your bank statement very systematic, as if you're employed, because that's how the system is, unfortunately. So you want to make the constant amount that comes in at a month end exactly on the same time, if possible on the same date. So if it's 40,000 rands or 50,000 or 10,000 US dollars or 1,000 euro, it's still fine. It's the same constant amount that comes. So then you'll be able to to get a lot of benefits as well as an entrepreneur, as a self-employed. And then of course your yearly one, it's basically, as I said, big projects, building a house, buying a house, buying a car, anything that's big. But it's all about compounding small profits that end up to be big profits. I just hope that this video has really blessed you, and if it has and has also set you up for the year, I believe that you're gonna just like and also share this with another friend that's in trading. Share it to the group chats out there, because a lot of people have the skill, but without the right mentality. That's why we say 95% of traders keep on losing money, not because they don't have the skill, but because they don't have the right psychology. We are busy focusing on technical analysis, but we leave mental analysis. Anyway, signing out as your brother in the kingdom.